shall be done. Indeed. Yes.
Whoops. Oh, well. Just got three places left, and then we can go on our mission. Oh yeah, I was listening. You're such a threat. I'm so concerned. Although Logan is someone you do want to worry about.
Who's here? I heard all
Hello.
About what you did to those Tevincers. Nice work.
Thank you. Let's have a look at yours.
Of course. Just keep it quiet.
Certainly. It's always good to have some of these. One last trip to Orzammar, then it's time to proceed with the missions. Let me check something. Just need one more. Actually, I'm being foolish. Oh, no, wait. He might have some poultices. I doubt it, but it's possible.
Have you seen my lunch? It's a piece of lichen bread with a spread of old cheese and shredded fried meat. I'm only asking because you never know who's going to get hungry. Right. Best in the trade, you know. I work the ore myself.
Okay, never mind. chlorophyll done?
At last, the rightful king is on the throne. In honor of our good King Balin, 2 silvers off anything you buy. I'll take your gold. You're good for that.
Got more business for me?
Sure, let me see where it is.
Of course.
One last thing.
News of the hour. Lord Balin victorious. Lord Harrowmont arrested and ridiculed in the street.
Let's see how big they are.
Greetings.
Better.
Careful fighting the Blight. I don't want little Endrin to grow up not knowing you.
Neither do I. Goodbye, sister. I love you. I'll do the best I can, and hopefully you'll be okay, too. Hopefully I'll be okay. Hopefully everyone in our family will be okay. You from the old, and those from the new. Goodbye. I love you. Time to go. Don't look back. I look forward to seeing little Endrin and telling him stories, if he's interested.
of the hour, supporters of disgraced Lord Caramon.
You have a lot of nerve coming here.
Is there some kind of problem?
Problem? Oh, I got a problem with your face. You keep it up and I'll fight you. I don't even care that you're some kind of wool-gnawing poetess.
Ah, you think I'm Hespeth?
Your disguise can't fool me, woman. That's right. You keep looking at me like that. I'll just go get my pants from that sodding dog.
Thank you. I appreciate it. That's where you belong. Okay. Okay, I can deal with that. Okay. As long as he's not harassing my people, that's okay.
I got a moment. Hey, sure. What about? All right then.
Okay.
Indeed. Yes.
You have found 12 love letters. Return them to the well-connected bartender in the noble tap Noble Tavern for a reward. But first, you are filthy, a beast. Such depravity I have never been forced to suffer. How words are so laden when they leave your lips is beyond decent imagining. Madam, I love you. Sir Ogold. Okay.
Well, aren't you sweet and attentive? Redcliffe? I know little of it except that it is the domain of the Earl of Redcliffe. Redcliffe? I wonder how the name came to be. Is the clay here red? There are places in this world where the clay is a bright, strange red, and often, in the legends of such places, it is the red of blood. The blood of a thousand men slaughtered in battle, or that of an innocent, unjustly slain. It stains the land that it may never be forgotten. Perhaps Redcliffe has one such tale. But I do not know it. Well, aren't you sweet and attentive?
Better now.
Well, aren't you sweet and attentive? Well, aren't you sweet and attentive? I thought you'd never ask.
Thank you, Leliana. That meant a lot.
Yes. Indeed.
Dwarven crafts. Fine dwarven crafts.
What can I get you, stranger?
Now discreetly makes note of the recognition you are owed. Thank you.
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
Excuse me, the Lady Queen has summoned me to see to her unmentionables. No, I'm from Redcliffe. Lady Isolde brought me here to be her chambermaid last spring. I've family here, though. I beg your pardon, sir, but I really can't be seen standing about. The housekeeper will have my head. Good day.
Okay.
You know, I could get to like this. The last time I came to Denerim, I stayed at an inn so filthy the bedbugs had fleas.
Your wish?
The occupation was a dark blot on Ferelden's history. Our people, who from time immemorial valued their freedom over all else, were forced to bow to our Elysian rule. The Empire declared our elves property and sold them like cattle. Chevaliers routinely plundered freeholds of coin, food, and even women and children, and excused it as taxation. And for 70 years no lands meets were held, for the Imperial Throne had declared our ancient laws a form of treason. Like I said, life of the city elves was really bad. And based on how things are in Valrio, it's possible it might have been worse than the Castles. Although, they are able to pull together as families. Still, the main point is with them. And this is very different from Zathrian. Ugh! Is that the Castles and the City Elves deserve better than what they've been given. And there are things that could be improved for the Dalish. But, there's abuses of power within that system. King Brandel was one of those who escaped. He tried to organize the other fugitive lords to retake their land. But Brandel was neither clever nor persuasive, and the nobles preferred to take their chances alone. Ferelden might still be little more than a territory of the Empire, were it not for the fact that his daughter had all the charisma that a royal father lacked. The Rebel Queen's rule began with a midnight attack on the Imperial Armory at Lothring. It was swift and successful, and with their pilfered arms, the rebels began a campaign against the Orlesians in earnest. But the turning point of the war came when a young freeholder joined the Queen's army. The lad, Loghain Mac Tyr, possessed a remarkable talent for strategy and quickly became the favorite advisor of young Prince Merrick. The Queen finally died at the hands of Orlesian sympathizers, anxious to curry favor with their painted masters, and Merrick took her place as the leader of the rebellion. Loghain became Merrick's right hand. Merrick and Loghain led the rebels in a new campaign against their Orlesian oppressors, culminating in the Battle of River Dane, where the last Chevaliers and Redanarum were crushed. With the capital once more in the hands of Ferelden's, the battle to free our people was finally over, but the battle to rebuild what had been lost had only just begun. From Ferelden, Folklore and History by Sister Petrine, Chantress Scholar.
Been here longer?
I heard Her Highness has a temper like a nest of rabid wolverines. Maybe the housekeeper sent Nigella as a sacrifice. I can't believe the Arl only gave Her Highness that tiny room.
He's always been stingy. Been here longer?
Yeah. I heard Her Highness has a temper like a nest of rabid wolverines. Maybe the housekeepers sent Nigella as a sacrifice.
I can't believe we are.
I got a moment's hey, sure.
What about?
All right then.
Very well.
Stand a lot up, or I'll have your eye.
Feast day fish, fluffy mackerel pudding. 2 stalks celery, 1 green pepper, 1/2 pound of poached mackerel, 1 small onion finely diced, 1 tablespoon mustard, 1 tablespoon salt, 1/2 teaspoon ground Antivan pepper, 8 tablespoons ground mace, dash of ground cardamom seed, 2 eggs beaten, 2 eggs boiled and sliced for garnish. This book is found in Arl Eamon's estate. Naturally falls open to this page. She's a dumbass.
Can't talk now, sir. Mistress Agatha would have my eye.
Dinner's not ready yet, and don't ask. It'll be served when it's done, and that's that. Now, show out of way.
Yes, ma'am.
This is a nice estate, isn't it?
What's
on your mind? It is no trouble.
I mean, the inside, the walls are okay. Still better where I came from.
Hello again, friend. It looks as though you're no worse for wear after your stay in Fort Draken.
Yeah. Did you know Nuck and Duncan very well?
We went through our joining together, more years ago than I like to remember. He was exactly the same back then, tough as stone and just as grizzled. I think he understood sooner than the rest of us how ugly a choice it is to let the few be sacrificed to protect the many.
Yeah.
Always left himself a soft spot for his recruits, though. Only way he ever let himself down.
Could you tell me more about that vault again?
It's located just off the market district in the northern alley past the Nord Noble Tavern. I'll sketch out the code which will let you pass the lock wheel. Inside you can take your pick of whatever equipment remains. It is the stockpile the wardens have kept for centuries for the defense of Denerim.
Well,
I'd be happy to tell you what I know. But it seems to me that you've picked the important parts up yourself.
Thank you,
Riva. Be firm in your beliefs, protect people from their own ignorance, and be as loyal as you can to your brothers, even knowing you'll share their deaths.
How many wardens are there?
It's tough to say. Only the fortress in Weishaupt has every record. But there are certainly a few dozen or hundreds in every nation in Thedas. The Anderfels are home to over 1,000. It's almost like the Archdemon chose Ferelden deliberately, knowing how unguarded it is.
Have you ever been to the fortress in Weishaupt? Oops.
Once only, and I'd rather not go again.
Oh.
It's far, lass, and very foreign. But the wardens there, they fight darkspawn like you and me, but they're shaped by the winters there in the forest. They're a cold group and don't care like they should about the rest of the world. Their king is weak, and many Anders look to the wardens to rule. I hate to say this, but some of them seem to want it that way.
How were the wardens founded?
It was near 1,200 years ago, and no one knows for sure, except that it began with a group of Anders soldiers. Apparently, they defected from their king's army, vowing that fighting the Blight was more important, and traveled all the way to Tevinter themselves. They were the first ones to track down the Archdemon Dumat, and the ones to slay him, though none survived the battle. But they had picked up followers by then, and it was they who formally founded the Order, and were recognized by Thedas.
Why has it been so long since the last Blight?
Archdemons don't awaken on their own, you know.
True.
It takes the Darkspawn, tunneling and tunneling, searching for centuries to find one. And with no one to lead them, it must be sheer chance, or maybe instinct, which leads them. What's surprising isn't that it takes so long between blights. What's surprising is that they succeed at all. But I imagine the old gods call to them, and it's that voice in the darkness which drives them through so many generations. The important thing to remember is, none of that matters. When you're facing Darkspawn, all you need to know is to stop them at all costs.
Okay, Riordan.
Hello again, friend.
Hi, Riordan.
It looks as though you're no worse than aware after your stay in Fort Draken.
What are your plans now?
When I'm well enough, I'm going to continue my journey toward Ostagar. Hopefully I'll be able to trace the heart of the Blight and where the Archdemon itself abides. If we want to defeat this Archdemon, we need to know where it is and how soon it might strike. If there were more of us, I would agree. But as it is, I don't think we can deprive all the armies you've gathered of a commander.
Need to get going.
Good luck to you, then. We will have to talk again when the Landsmeet is more settled.
Yes. It was nice talking to Papa Duncan.
I haven't been here in a while. They've changed the dining room. Ask away. Of course.
Never mind.
My lady, she will be forever grateful, Warden.
I have spoken with Alistair. Perhaps this mad betrothal won't be quite the curse it first seemed.
Good to hear.
servant asks if I would like a change of clothes, I will set the house on fire. What comes, my friend?
Never mind.
If one more servant asks if I would like a change of clothes, I will set the house on fire. What comes, my friend?
I'd like to ask you something.
So, full of questions, are you?
Never mind. Got that one place to check.
It is begun.
Indeed. Yes.
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
Very well.
The first show map the Enderfell's enclosed drawings of strange beasts.
It shall be done.
I guess I can sell it for some money. Most of this stuff.
Dwarven craft. Find dwarven craft.
And your friends are formidable folk, indeed. It's good to have you along on the road. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Hopefully this will cheer Alistair up. Help him deal with the wedding.
This shield. It's Duncan's, isn't it? That's his crest.
I thought maybe you might want it.
Thank you. Truly, I had no idea his shield wasn't with him. This is perfect. I don't know how else to express my gratitude. This means a great deal to me. I can't believe you remembered us at all.
For you? Of course I remembered.
I'll treasure this. Thank you.
You're welcome.
My thanks. If there's anything I can do for you, please, please tell me.
Let me see your wares, but Ann.
I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected. And with your discount.
Flashing from a Nug's stomach, this fascinating dwarven device is like a loose-fitting nozzle. Muzzle that sits beneath the beard and keeps the drinker's alcohol accessible even after he loses feeling in his arms. Yeah. There you go, my mighty Ogryn.
It'll do, sure.
Yeah.
There you are. I was thinking, we've been through a lot together now. We're like old war buddies. So I figured why not invite you to share a drink, huh? A drink from my own stash, my family's recipe, and dedicated to my comrades in arms.
Finally, I get to taste Ogryn's famous brew.
Yes! The Warden steps up. You handled that like a champion, my friend. Most impressive. How do you feel?
That's enough.
That's the spirit.
I just wanted to tell you, after all we've been through, you're like family to me. Closest thing I've had in
Uncle
years.
Uncle Ogryn. A toast. I feel the same way, Uncle Ogryn.
Warden, I do believe I'm getting all misty-eyed. But that could be because those beans are getting chatty, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So, do you want to talk about something?
Sure. We know more about you.
What about?
Do you feel homesick for Orzammar yet?
I do. A bit. A little bit.
I don't miss that fucking place. It was horrible for me.
Aye, it was. But it's also home. Flies live in piles of dung, but I bet they'd miss it when they're gone.
True.
Still, I can't go back even if I wanted to. I'd rather be dead than be castless in Orzammar. Oh, right, sorry. But you have to admit, given the choice, a nice clean burial sounds pretty appealing, no? I guess I'd rather be a useless lump of a dwarf out here than a useless lump of a dwarf back there.
I don't mind what he said. It does suck to be there. I don't find you useless, Ogryn.
Nice of you, Warden. But I know what side of the house the Lou is on.
Oh, you're useful.
Let's go find something to kill, huh? All this talk makes my hands twitchy.
Sure. Okay. That went well. And hey, he likes cheese. Good for him. I love cheese, too. Nice bunch of cheese and meat and apple. Yeah, eat that food, buddy. And Leliana, we can eat it with Ogryn.
You there. I've been watching you. Where can I get some sauce for that rump roast?
And just when we were getting along... Oh no, Ogryn, go sleep it off.
Ooh, that's just what I had in mind.
Not with me.
Go and make yourself ready, woman. I'll be right there to see to it.
No. No. You drunken fool.
Hey, Warden. You gotta hear this one. This human walks into a tavern. And there's an elf there. And she says... she says...
Well, it's nice to know that he forgot his disgusting, depraved comments from before. I don't have time for Joe. And then what?
She says, I don't...
Okay. Yeah, you couldn't perform even if I wanted to do it with you, and I'd rather puke. Sex and vomit don't go together, Ogryn. You're disgusting. I would not ever sleep with you in a million years.
Right here, old pal. What about?
Maybe some other time.
All right.
Talk more later.
Aye. All right, then.
Yeah, I would not ever sleep with you, you dumbass. Just dumb shit. Everything was fine, and it was funny, and we had drinks with Ogryn, and then he gets sexist and tries to go after me and have sex with me. Ugh. And he's disgusting. This guy cleaned his beard. I mean, ugh. God. No wonder Branka ran off with Hespeth. Ogryn's so awful, he probably... never mind. That's about the last time I'm going to put up with Ogryn's crap when he starts making propositions toward me. That's about the last time. I've really about just had it almost completely with him.
Very well.
I feel kind of sorry for him, but when he does stuff like that with Branka stuff, no wonder she left him. Mm-hmm.
Indeed.
All right. Yeah, I'm done talking with him. After that, I'm just done. I'm not going to talk to him anymore. I'm done with it. At least for a while. I'm not going to talk to him for a while. Yeah, I've about had it with him. His nonsense. I've had it with, you know. Really sick of it. Just no more of it. No more. Ogryn, if you want to go out and kill stuff, you need to fucking behave. Because I've about had it with you and this crap that you pull. I mean, seriously, I'm about done with it. No more. No more. I'm done with it. I'm done with it. I don't want to hear no more. I'm sick of it. I don't want to hear no more. Enough's enough. Okay? Everything was going fine. We're doing the funny thing with the booze. We were getting along okay. We're going to have a little bit of cheese and meat and fruit. Apples and cheese with Leliana and sit around the fire and maybe invite Alistair and Zevron and who the heck else wants to join in. Pickling Batty Buddy, anybody. Morgan probably wouldn't do it, but that's okay. Dark Sister is Dark Sister. Maybe even Mom would step up there. But then you had to get stupid and annoying and show you haven't learned anything.